say simple, but it's not really. Some of you probably wouldn't say it's simple, but it's a simple hinge, really. So that is going to be attached to this part here. Which is the head of Psyduck. As you can see here, you can see the scale, my face to Psyduck's face, or head, Psyduck's head to my head. He looks kind of a bit creepy without the beak, because it's got just two eyes staring right into you. But yeah, so the shape again, it's lots of different pieces here that I carved out to form this shape. It does take a lot of time. See, there's lots of support pieces inside that's been carefully shaped for, you know, the sides and stuff, and carefully cut on the edges and the sides and everything. This is where the tail's gonna go. I haven't made the tail yet, but, you know, slowly in time. This is why these videos take a while to make, because there's just so many pieces to put together, let alone, you know, making the video itself, you know, among other things as well. So, and this is where I will put my hand. It's through the side here. Originally it was going to be from underneath, but I realized that it's a bit too big, so and it's not really comfortable to have the arm from underneath, because it's so big. It might not well, it just wouldn't look great. Side here. And so yeah, that's the body. So that's the third piece, and then the arms and the legs, or the feet, should I say. shapes are going to be a bit different, hinges are going to be different, so on and so forth, and even materials will probably be different as well, but this one, Psyduck, is just a sort of a rounded kind of character. It's not like a human-based one like Sylvando, so I wouldn't say it's, well, there's just less pieces to it. I wouldn't say it's less complicated. Excited.